Good morning, welcome to day 4 of the Sunshine Readathon. We are like the halfway point. I'm so stoked. Okay, and I've actually read a lot. I've already finished 2 books. I'm close to finishing Blackout. I have 2 more acts to read. I'm gonna read 1 more today. So hyped. And then I read 130 some pages of Rayberry. Hopefully I'm going to finish this today. I have 2 live shows today, so I don't know how much vlogging I'm gonna do. I like how slowly but surely the vlogs are getting slower and slower. It started at 30 something minutes, and then it was at like 24, and then it was at 17. So we'll see what today ends up being. But yeah, I uploaded the vlog already. It is 10:07. Chugging water. I think I'm gonna go make coffee. I think I'm just gonna have like eggs for breakfast. But this morning I won't be reading. I'm going to be working on my sides. So that's also probably gonna slow down my reading. But hopefully I'll get off book before the live shows. And then that way during the live shows I can really enjoy reading and relaxing and hanging out with my lovely guests. But I'm really looking forward to today. Off to new beginnings. That reminds me, I haven't told you the challenges I've finished so far. So I've read Poet X, which I think I'm going to use for Golden Hour, which is to read a heartwarming book. So I'm going to check off that challenge. I am currently working on the buddy read. So that's Dawnbreaker, which is Blackout. I'm reading it with a few of you guys who voted for it, and I'm very excited. And the third challenge that I have, well, the second challenge that I've fully completed, because the buddy read isn't done yet, but the second challenge is Daylight's Flare, which is to read a book in a day. Technically, I read Poet X in a day, but I also read Punching the Air in a day. So, boom, baby. I'm thinking I might use Rayberry as first blush for queer romance, solely because there are queer romances in it, even though they're not at the forefront of the story, because I feel like the politics and the found family is at the forefront of the story, but the council members are very polyamorous, and there's an asexual character there, which we love. Love it. So I think I might be using Rayberry for first blush. We'll see. I might try and squeeze in Perfect on Paper, which is my original idea to do this, but I don't know. I'm starting to think I'm not gonna be able to finish as many books because of the self-tape, because it does take a lot of hours for me to memorize my lines, and this character is specifically very witty, and like one of her lines is the infantilization of the generation, and I don't know why that word is so hard in my mouth. It's just like infantilization. I have to keep saying it and get comfortable with it. But yeah, I have to pretend, put my smarty pants on and be like, I know everything. Ooh. So I'm gonna be working towards that goal, finishing Rayberry. Like I said earlier, you know, but I finished 2 challenges, working on 2 more. Boom.
Hey, so I just finished my live show with Jesse. They are the most incredible human being ever. That live show was really us just chatting. So we did sprints, don't get me wrong, but like we had some great chats. So if you didn't watch it, you should go check it out. Make sure to follow them. I have their account linked below, but they are Jesse from Bow Ties and Books. Bow Ties and Books is their YouTube and Instagram handle too. So go check them out. They're amazing. That live stream really gave me life, and I'm so happy. I read a lot too, so I read the 4th act of Blackout. I'm 200 pages in. I have about, I think, 70 pages left, so I'm gonna be doing that last bit tomorrow. I did enjoy this act especially because it was Angie Thomas's story, and it was all about like self-love and choosing yourself, instead of like the other stories have all been about like romantic love, which is cute, don't get me wrong, but I did enjoy seeing a love story that was about loving yourself first, because I think that's a really impactful story that not many people share. And also I'm still reading Rayberry, so I think I got like 30 pages into that, but I'm talking fast and hurrying because I need to eat something really fast, and then I'm going to go back on live, and I'm gonna have my live show with Nina Reads in like 30 minutes. So we're rushing, we're running, we're shoving food in our faces so quickly. So yeah, and I really have to pee, but it was such a good time. I had to come in and say that. Love Jesse. They are the best. I just finished the live show with Mina, and it was really fun. I love talking to her. She's great. But wow, am I pooped. I am so tired. Oh, and my roommate made cookies. So I'm gonna have that. But I decided to actually because she made them in the middle of the sprint and I went down to grab one, but then I was like, I'm gonna be good and eat it with dinner, so I'm not like eating too many carbs, just like snacking throughout the day, trying to be a good bean. But yeah, let me tell you about what I read.
I feel like my camera's crooked, but I don't care to fix it. I already told you guys that I finished Act 4 of Blackout, and I did really like that one. I feel like that one promoted a little bit more self-love, which is so sweet. But then I read a lot of Brave Bear, because obviously I had two live shows today, so lots of reading happened today, which I'm so hyped for. But I still haven't finished Ray Bear, so hopefully tomorrow I will finish Blackout, Ray Bear, and then start a new book on day 5. So I'll have 4 books done by day 5. Ooh, time is crunching, and I didn't even do the challenges today. I wanted to do some more challenges. We'll see tomorrow. But tomorrow I also want to film my self-tape, so we'll see what happens. Okay, but I managed to get to page 268 in Ray Bear, so I read about 130 pages. I'm so happy. I'm loving this reread. I'm just getting all the gems that I kind of overlooked last time. Let me show you a quote I really liked. It was on page 264. It's not a spoiler, but it says, "And if I learned anything from serving in the Imperial Guard, it's that leadership isn't good or evil. It's what you choose to do with it." Mic drop. Love it. And here's another quote from a magical spirit. He says, "I've never understood why mortals make things so complicated. M's story for men and women has always been simple. You are equals, built to work side by side. But when it comes to power, mortals have always loathed simplicity," which is so funny. So yeah, I feel like this story has a lot of like, not just feminist tones, but like, talks a lot about equality and like a lot of assumptions we have about the binary. So love that. We love to see it. So I'm very much enjoying Ray Bearer. So tomorrow I hope to finish it. I think I have, let's see how many hours I have left in the audiobook. Ooh, I have just 2 hours left in the audiobook. That's fabulous. I can totally finish that tomorrow, either during the reading sprints or after. So that's great. So excited. I'm not gonna lie, I'm so tired and I don't want to do my work, but I should do my work, you know what I mean? Like, I should get off book because I didn't do it this morning like I said I would, like a dum-dum. Okay, so I'm going to wrap up the vlog here. Firstly, thank you for watching. It really, really means a lot to me. Thank you so much. And today's spotlight is going to go to Amber Burns. She is a booktuber, but also like just lifestyle content. I really love her stuff. It's very motivational, super inspiring. Her Instagram is freaking goals, but I also love her YouTube content. So definitely check her out. I'll have her channel linked below, as well as Mina's, because we did a live show together. So definitely check them out. And then let me spotlight one of you guys. Let me check and see the comments from a previous video. So funny, I'm losing subscribers for some reason. What's happening? Okay, so for my subscriber, like friend shout out from you guys who come and just send me so much love and support, I will be shouting out Books and Joe, and I'll put a little screenshot here, who said, "Good luck with the readathon. I wish I could join, but I have to finish my book club book this week and it's a chunker." So best of luck to you. I also really appreciate your comment. Thank you for commenting, supporting, watching my videos. It's so crazy to me that people watch my videos and like my content, but I feel so appreciative. But yeah, that's it for today's video. Let's hope tomorrow is super productive when I film my self-tape, do my live show, and try and tackle at least like 2 challenges, because I've missed a couple and I need to catch up. I need to make some reels or post some videos or photos or something. I need to catch up. But I keep forgetting to talk about how many pages I read in total. I'm so silly. 135 plus 50. The total page count for today is 185, which is like a few pages more than yesterday. So maybe we're on an uphill incline again. Because the first 2 days I was reading 400 plus pages. Now it's around just 180. Let's see if tomorrow we can get it to 300 pages. Let's, fingers crossed, I know I can do it. Nonetheless, I hope this video gave you more sunshine, and I will see you tomorrow with day 5? Yo, I'm losing track. All the days are blurring together. I'm just gonna drink my coffee and work on my sides. Oh, I have so much work to do. Okay, I'm gonna stop complaining. I'll see you tomorrow.